Okay, so 9th standard students, a very good morning and warm welcome to the online session of JSE English High School. So, as of now, we are going to the part 2 of your social science and we are in the geography part and we are going to the chapter 7. The chapter 7 is transport of Karnataka. We have already completed the chapter 6, that is the mineral resources of Karnataka. Now we are in the transport of Karnataka, and in transport of Karnataka, in the last video, what we have learned the introduction of to the transport, what transport it is, what are the types of transport, road transport, railway transport, water transport and air transport. Okay, then we are going to learn about means separately about these types of transport of Karnataka. Means we are starting with the road transport. We already have learned about the importance, okay, development of road transport, means before independence, after independence, what it is, okay, so how it was, how the kings and emperors was using, how the roads has been changed from the unmetal road to metal road, everything. Now we are in the kinds of road. Only we have just gone through what are the kinds of road? What are the kinds of road? National highway, state highway, district road and village road. Now, one by one we will go. The first one is the national highway. National means throughout the country. Okay, what is this national highway? Roads which link important cities, capital of states and ports are called national highways. National highways are all over our city, are available all over the country. It is connecting all the states with the capital of the state, the port, so that people can go, the transport should be there, so that the export and import business can be happen. These are well planned wide roads and two lane, four lane and six lane roads. Okay, so these are well planned roads and the quality is also very good. These are all metallic road. Okay, metallic road means you don't think that it's a this one, it's made of iron and steel. Okay, metal means there are several types of metal. Tar is there. Okay, asphaltic this one roads are there. These are this type of roads. These are having longevity. Okay, for 30-40 years no potholes will come, like that only. They are under central government. These roads are being maintained by central government. Okay, maintained, developed, everything. The supervision, everything is done by the central government and they are managed by the National Highway Authority of India. What is this National Highway Authority of India? If you go for Sadarli also, you can see NHAI. That is NHAI means National Highway Authority of India. That road is connecting. See, from Sadarli, you can go through Chikmagalur to you can go to Andhra Pradesh. Not only Andhra Pradesh, you can go to Tamil Nadu, you can go any part of the country. Okay, through these highways. At present, there are 14 national highways in Karnataka. Okay. Their total length is 4,491 kilometer. It's huge. Okay. So now we will be discussing about which are the states from where the national highways passed out. Uttara Kannada, Vijayapura. Then your Vijayapura means it is a state. Okay, it is a district. Don't think this Vijayapura. Uttara Kannada, Vijayapura. Then Belagavi, Shivamoga, Bangalore urban and rural Tumkuru. Then Dakshin Kannada and Ballari district have more national highways. National highways passes through this district. Raichur and Kodagu district have no national highway. These are the two places where no national highways passes through this place. National highway NH4, NH7 comes under the National Highway Authority's Golden Quadrilateral Highway Project as well as Corridor Project. They have six lane. Six lane means six vehicle can go, six vehicle can come. It's a very wide type of land, wide type of road. Okay, you can't, it's like a playground only. Okay, see, 12 vehicles can be stand at a time in a row. Okay, the other main national highways passing through the states are, okay, NH206, NH209, NH212, NH13, NH17, NH48. These are important, but all total, how many national highways Karnataka is having? Karnataka is having 14 national highways. Now we will go for State highways. State means you can know, you know we are having 29 states. Out of that, Karnataka is one of the state. So these are the state roads which are being maintained by the state government. Means the Karnataka government is responsible for the maintenance and development of this road. So what is this? Roads which link the capital with capital city of Bangalore with district headquarters. A state is again divided, a country is divided into state, and a state is divided into different districts. Okay, so now we have to go see the national highway will connect state after state. State highways, they will connect the district of the states. Okay, so roads which link the capital city of Bangalore with district headquarters, major towns and other highways are called state highways. Okay. See, from Devanahalli, that NH is going. Before going to Devanahalli, that highway is going. Okay, that is under NHAI, means central government. But the lane which cut off and which is coming towards our Vijayapura, then going to Chikballapur, okay, that is the state highway road. The construction and maintenance of these roads are taken care and governed by state government. Karnataka has 20,905 kilometers of state highways. Okay, Belagavi has the longest state highways, whereas Bangalore has the least. Bangalore urban has the least. Belagavi has the longest state highway. Now we will go for district road. These are not highways, these are district roads. Roads which link district headquarters. See, the NH has already linked the state after state. The state highway has linked the within the state the district headquarters. Now we will go for the district road. What district road is being? Roads which link district road district headquarters with taluks. Okay, like Devanahalli is a taluk, Siddharatha is a taluk, Chikballapur is a taluk. The road which are connecting these are known as the district road. So road which link district headquarters with taluk headquarters, major towns, villages, railway stations and major highways are called district roads. The construction, maintenance, supervision of these roads is under the Zila Parishad. Okay, Zila Parishad, in the political science you will know, you will get it know what is Zila Parishad. And Zila Parishad is responsible for the construction, for the development and for the maintenance of this type of roads. Karnataka has 47,836 kilometers of district highways. So what is the total length of district highway? It is 47,836 kilometers. Tumkuru district has maximum district highways. Tumkuru district has the maximum district highways and Raichur has the least. Okay. Village road. Now we will go for village road. The last one is the village road. So village road, with the name only you will understand what is this. Villages. Okay, India is having lots of villages. So there should be a road which are connecting the village after village. Roads which link the taluk, district headquarters, district roads, what they are doing? They are connecting the district with the taluk. Village road are doing what? They are doing the link between the taluk and the village. Okay, roads which link taluk headquarters with village and district highways are called village roads. The construction and maintenance of this road is under the taluk panchayat and village panchayat. Quality of these roads are not good, and in some parts it is very difficult to travel on these roads. These roads are not as metallic road or tar road like the highways of the state or the national highway. They are poor in quality. So it is very difficult during rainy season, it is very difficult to reach one villages. Okay, and even proper maintenance is not getting done. So they are having a poor quality. Karnataka has, but it is having the longest road facilities in Karnataka. Though the quality is not good, but the collection or the infrastructure is very high. It is 147,212 kilometers of village roads. In addition to these above mentioned road types, means this four, national, state, district, village, in addition to these road types mentioned above, there are multipurpose roads and roads under local administration. Small, small roads are there. The roads which are coming to your street, they are also being maintained and constructed and developed by some authority body. Also, roads of public works department, public work department, forest department. There, if you go to forest, there also you will get some road. They are under the, that forest authority is responsible for the maintenance of that road. Irrigation department, town municipality and city corporation. These are the roads which are the roads apart from these four. These are the four main roads, okay? So you have to focus on these four roads and the questions in your essay, this one. Final exam, it will come from here. You should have the concept. What is this national highway? What is this state? Which are linking? This is linking national highway. It is linking the state to state. State highway, what they are doing? They are doing the state with the district. What district is doing? District is doing district with the taluk. What village road is doing? They are linking between the taluk and the village. Okay. So with this, the types of roads has been finished. So in the next video, we will be going through the railway transport. Okay. Thanks a lot. Okay. Stay fit.